You're almost there. You starting to get goosebumps, or is it just me? The Delta's a weird place. He said he got stuck somewhere over there by those cypress knees. Bingo. Those are the supplies. You got everything? Thanks. This is doing us a huge favor. Hey, are the shadows playing tricks, or is that a briefcase I'm seeing on my feed? Let me make a quick call. Hey, Mrs. Tackett. My new counselor's out where Steve dropped the flood supplies, and there's a briefcase hanging from a tree branch. You know if that's... Uh-huh. Yep. Yep. Yes, ma'am. Give me just a sec. She wants to talk to you.
Well, Miss Davis has got you out on a fine excursion this time of night. Betty Tackett here, chairwoman of the Mississippi Delta Big Game Club. I hate to ask, Sugar, but can you grab the briefcase? Steve's a little ornery and he'll pitch a fit if he don't get his papers back.
You'll have to... Well, nothing to it. Hear that, Mrs. Tackett? You are phenomenal. What happened to that rookie kid I got my hunting license with who couldn't hit a broadside shot on a stationary target?
Loud and clear. I'm gonna extend you an invite if you keep that up. I'm down for the count since I broke my neck, but Steve will get you an application. Hell, he owes you.
Let's take that later, why don't we? We gotta let you go, Mrs. Tackett.
All the best now. Don't be a stranger, y'all.
Betty's lovely, but she's as southern as all get out, as they say in these parts, with everything that entails. Any markings on that briefcase? Not that I don't believe it's Steve's, it's just... I don't see anything suspicious. Let's get those supplies to the people who need them. There's an outpost not far from here. Can you swing by and drop the briefcase and supplies off there? Maybe get your breath back, too. Just leave the stuff on the table there. I'll let Steve know. Thanks. Oh, Betty again? Can you pull her up on speakerphone?
Hey, Sugar, can I trouble you for a favor? The boys are having a meeting tonight to discuss our flood relief efforts. And it gets real chilly in the evenings this time of year. Well, usually they get a fire going, but right now... There ain't a single log of dry firewood anywhere in the state. And you know we've got elderly members. I believe you'll find a space heater in that outpost where you left the supplies. Could you be a dear and drop it off at our lodge?
Well, I'd hate to think of someone catching hypothermia. By the way, the Big Game Club has been working together with the African American Hunting Club I'm a member of on flood relief efforts. We've got some history. Not gonna lie, they weren't super enthusiastic about some transplant from Chicago buying up land and opening a summer camp here. Even Betty, and even though I've been coming here since I was little, I get these kids. But we've both got our priorities straight. The future of the community is what matters. Speaking of, we haven't had enough hands on deck to tend to everyone's needs up until now. So there are a couple of errands around the reserve that still need doing. I'll let you know if you're near somewhere you can help out. Let's head over to the Big Game Club's lodge. Make sure they get the heater before their meeting later on. Well, here's the lodge. Not gonna lie, I don't make a habit of spending time here. I guess check the door? Huh. I thought it was just good old-fashioned Southern hospitality to leave your place unlocked in these parts. But who knows what kinds of valuables they've gotten there. Some of the keys are faded. Not the most robust security system. 0, 1, 4, 5, and 6. 5 factorial combinations. That's 120, and that's without repeating digits. And my students say math is pointless. Betty must know the code, right? Let's call her. Hey, Mrs. Tackett, sorry to bother you again. My counselor's out dropping off the heater, but the door is locked. Would you happen to have the key code to hand?
Unfortunately, I do not, Miss Davis. I've been out of commission so long with my neck, you understand.
Do you know who does have the code, then? Mr. Ernie, maybe?
I think it's best you just leave the heater outside on the porch there. The boys will be along for the meeting shortly.
Okay, if that works for you. All the best, Mrs. Tackett.
Bye-bye now.
Best do as she says, I guess. I just wonder why they're so reluctant to give us the code. Can you take a peek inside the window there? That's 3 of the same damn heater. What? Let me try Betty again. No answer. Well, maybe Southerners are just super sensitive to the cold. My mama just huddled up with a blanket, but I guess she was made of sterner stuff than some of these rich folks. I don't want to think the worst. Let's give them the benefit of the doubt, and I'll mention it to Betty later. Okay. All the really urgent things are out of the way, but I've got to be honest with you, Rookie. There's another reason you're here. Let me show you what I'm trying to protect. Head over to the Camp Haven bunks, and I'll explain on the way. Last about trust building, leadership, community. You get it. I know you do. See that broken tire swing? We got lucky here. That and a few deck chairs blown off course are the worst damage we suffered. There should be some extra rope inside. Can you get it swinging again? I knew I had some lying around here somewhere. A tire swing and a lazy Delta summer. Right, can you take a look around? I know some of the kids who reported the weird noises stayed in these bunks. Well, I wasn't wrong about them being on too much sugar. Where does this lead? Scorched grass. It's early summer and the ground is soaked. You remember our fire safety classes, right? Literally the first damn thing you're told, no building fires near anything flammable, grass included. If this was one of our counselors' idea of a prank, I'm gonna have to give them a talking to. Barely been back here since our last session. The flooding sure hasn't helped. What's that? That's a kid's handwriting. Witches, scorched grass, a woman living in the woods. We really do have to limit their sugar intake. But there are patches of scorched grass here. Oh, this is a map of Mississippi Acres. Must be the other spots where kids had heard noises. I've heard plenty of ghost stories set around these parts, but this is... Hello, ma'am. What can we do for you?
Excuse the interruption, Ms. Davis, but I've had some residents of Jonesville call me up reporting a gator sighting. They got little kids, and it ain't a good idea to go back if a big old mean one's made his nest there. I suspect he washed up with the high water. You got your counselor on the line there. Could you go and take a look, sugar? I'll send you the details.
Yeah, we're on it. We'll let y'all know how it goes.
If it's a nuisance gator, we can decide what to do with it there and then. I appreciate it.
Most folks around here know how to handle an alligator, but we don't take chances where kids are concerned. Can you go take a look?
Hey,
about you. Gators are lazy sons of guns at the best of times. I don't get why it... Oh, of course. Someone was on its trail. A catch pole? They were serious about this. It takes a lot to rip that snare. This thing must have been pissed. And we're dealing with some total amateurs. Gator guys, this ain't.
Thank you.